Everybody, welcome back to my channel. This is Martha. If this is your first time here, welcome to Kushter Beauty. Today we are going to be doing this makeup look. We did a full face using the James Charles palette. I'm so sorry, really I am. I try, but my brain just freezes. I promise you, it freezes. Anyway, if you're interested in seeing how we got this look, then stay tuned. But before we get into the video, if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button, turn on the notification bells, and that way you know every time Crazyville uploads a new video. Without further ado, let's get started.
Okay, everybody, let's get into it. First, I'm going to go in and moisturize with the Glowing Chic Chalk Glowing Moisturizer. It's from OK Beauty. I got this in my Etsy bag. That review will be coming up. If it's not already up, it will be up right after this video. And I'll just put a little bit of it on my face. We got to moisturize because I am dry, very dry. We've got to get all moisturized. Now we're going to go in with our primer. And today I'm going to use the No Problem primer from Touch and Soul. I got this in a Prism Pop tester bag, and I absolutely love all these primers. Like I said, if anybody is interested in signing up for Prism Pop to get free tester bags, they send them out every week. I'm going to leave a link down below where you can sign up for it. It's basically just a review site. You go on and review the products that you actually, that you already have. And you get coins just for logging in every day. But they send out emails every week about the tester bags, and all you do is go on and fill out the tester bag application, and they let you know within, like, I think it's like a day or two, it might be a little bit longer, if you got in. And then they ship it out to you, and all that they ask is that you review all of the products, and I think you have like 10 days to review them, which I need to do. I guess we're just gonna go in with the Elizabeth Arden foundation. I'm gonna take a brush. This is from Woosh Beauty. This is the number 4 brush. And just dip it in there and just start tapping it on. I really like this foundation. I used to not like it, but I really like it. I guess it just depends on how heavy you put it on. And I don't put, at least I don't think I put a whole lot. And I like it. It just gives you good coverage. And I've got this situation going on right here. I have no idea what it is. It was a sunspot, I know that for sure, but it's turned red and started flaking, and I guess I need to go have it checked out. And I don't know if y'all have noticed my new background. So I'm trying anything to get something that's half decent looking, and I'm hoping this works out because I like the lights. But only time will tell after I edit this video. if I like it or not. Okay, we got foundation on, and we're just gonna, I'm gonna use my Wish palette. It's the fold out face palette. This thing is so handy and convenient. I'm telling you, it's got everything in it that you need. But we're gonna go in and use the other end of that brush and go into that concealer, and a little bit of this goes a very long way. So you wanna just start out with just a little bit. If not, you will be blending for days. And I do mean for days. Because I dug into it the first time that I used it. I didn't think I was ever going to get it blended out. Which is good, I guess. Because you don't have to use a lot, but it gives you the coverage that you need, and that means it's going to last a while. You're not going to have to turn around and buy it again in a week or so. I really prefer the cream contour. This, I have no idea what the name of this is. But I'm going to take a flat top kabuki brush like this and just dab that in there and just start dabbing it on the cheeks. You don't want to go below the hollow of your cheek though. Just want to emphasize those cheekbones. And if you're like me, you got to carve your cheekbones out so people can actually see them. And do that forehead. Mine anyway, if you've got a little bitty forehead, you don't have to do this. But I tell you, my forehead is humongous. I'm gonna do another brush. I'm gonna go back in with that foundation brush and just go around the edges of that. Just to make sure it's blended good. Okay, then we're going to go some on the jawline. Just like so. And we're just going to powder contour our nose. When you do that on your neck, you need to bring it down just a little bit. But voila! We are contoured. I'm going to go with the AOA Studios Perfect Finishing Press Powder. You get this off Shop Miss A for $1. And I just don't think you can beat that. And it's really good powder. I like it anyway. I like it to set my under eyes with. Because it gives you some brightness under your eyes. And then I just lightly dust the other places that I put that concealer. Because we've got other powders. I'm just looking in the mirror, making sure we got that powdered in. Just like so. Oh, when I used the Omnia BOM 110 for that powder up under my eyes. That. And we have a powder to powder the rest of our face. That is, of course, my favorite, and I just can't find it. Oh, there it is. It's from Metaluso. It's the Mill Collection Master Blender Luminous Powder. I love this. It's such a pretty powder, and it gives your face just such a pretty glow to it. I mean, not without highlight, just like kind of gives you that glow from the end. See there? From within. Without adding a lot of color. Now, I have used it for bronzer, but I took it and built it up, and I was really, really light at the time, but now I'm just loving it as a all over powder, but see the sheen that it gives your skin, and it just makes it look so healthy with no powdery look, and I just love that. Because sometimes I can get carried away with powders. I'm gonna go in with this. Okay, this is a Do Care, a brush from Do Care. You can buy these off Amazon, I think, but I found them on Instagram, and these are really good brushes. They are so soft. But we are going to go in with bronzer, and I'm just going to use my Makeup Revolution Mega Bronzer in the One Cool, and just swirl a brush in it, tap off the excess, and just bronze it away. Oh, I need to contour my nose, and I'm gonna, that's not the right brush. This is the number 2 Perfector from Woosh Beauty, and we're gonna go back into that Woosh palette right here and go into this contour color. Just get a little bit of it and just go right down the nose. I have not perfected my nose contour yet. I haven't spent a lot of time onto it, but I need to spend more time and kind of figure this out, because I have a crooked nose and I'd really like to try to make it look a little bit straighter. And just go over to top of it with the brush to kind of blend it in. And that is that. And we're going to go in with highlighter next. Okay. It's, I can't say the name, but you get this off of, King Beauty, Q-I-N-G Beauty. And this is it. This is so cute. This little heart. Let me see if I can get it open. And this is the highlighter. I just think that it's so cute. And just hit the high points of our face. But I just have not found a foundation that I've, a lot of people hear, a lot of people, oh, this is it, it's the best, it's the best. And I just haven't found one that has done that for me. I've been thinking of trying the, okay, now which one is it? I can't remember if it's Urban Decay. I think it is the Urban Decay. I cannot promise though. I'll have to look it up and find it. But it looks pretty good, because I've seen a lot of people talk about it, and they said that it is really good. And I would like to try it. I think it's the Urban Decay. I'm going to do my eyebrows. Did my eyebrows and prime my eyelids. And we are going to jump in to some eyeshadow. I'm going to be using the James Charles palette. This is the mini palette. This is my favorite palette. I use this all the time. And I'm trying to decide what color I actually want to do. I want to use this green right here. It's just so pretty. But we're going to start out with, let's go in with this for this one right here, for transition color, and see how that works. bottom, which is going to go right above the crease limit. Because I have hooded eyes, and when you have hooded eyes, you have to raise everything up. So that's why I go above my crease instead of in my crease. And then we're going to get a little bit smaller fluffy brush. This is an e.l.f. blending brush. The first one was a Jessup 221 was the first one that I used, the big fluffy one for the transition. And then we're going to go in to this color right here next to it. Just get that in there. And we're going to go right below that transition color. And we're not going to add a whole lot at one time. We're going to build up the intensity of it and get it where we want it. So you can always add more, but it's not easy blending that out when you've got too much on. So less is more. So we're going to need an even smaller blending brush. That is too small. Let's see. This one will probably work. This is a Duke hair brush too. Let me clean that off and make sure it's not got any other color onto it. So I don't want to ruin this. And how we are going to do this is, first I'm going to go in, I guess, with this lighter green right here. I hope this works out. And just go right in the crease with it, and more toward the outer V, like so. I love this palette. I use it all the time. I'm sure everybody is sick of seeing me use it. I've got to get new palettes. I want the Jaclyn Hill Volume 2 palette so bad. I just haven't got it yet. But I will. Okay. And where we put that green, we're going to go in with some of this brown right here. Not a lot of it, just a little, just to deepen that up. We want it to still be green, but we want it to be a deep green. And go back in that green and just add a little bit more green to it, because we don't want to lose the green. We just want to deepen it. Now we're going to go into that green, first green we were talking about. If I can find a good flat brush. And we have that here, and this is another Duke hair brush too. And we're going to go in to that real pretty, all I know to call it, army green. I don't have the sheet that tells me the names of the colors, so I point, and we're just going to put it right there. I love this color. I think it is so pretty. I want to take. That was really dramatic, wasn't it? Let's see. I need a little brush. a little brush. Let me clean it off first, because we fix to add some yellow in the middle of this mix. Okay, and this brush is from, it's a Jessup 237. This is the little brush. I want to go into this yellow, and we're going to put yellow, I'll never say yellow, this yellow, and we're going to put it right there in the inner corner. Let me hold this down a little bit more so y'all can see. Right there is where we want it. Yes, 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 yes. I don't know if y'all can see this on camera, but it looks really cute. Trust me. My lighting is no good today. I can tell that already. Shoot. Why? Went off camera and did my other eye, and it looks like I've got a little bit of fallout right there. Let me brush that off. I just did my other eye and put some of this green, this darker green, under my eye, and now we're just gonna put on some eyeliner and some lipstick, if I can find
it. This is
a lash liner from Miss Pink USA. You can find them on Instagram. This pen actually is an eyeliner, but it's also an adhesive for your eyelashes. So you only need one product to do it, and all you do is just line your lips like you usually do with your eyeliner, like so, and then take, let's see what lashes. I guess I should have picked some lashes before I put the eyeliner on, because it will probably be dry before I get to them. It takes me so long. We're just going to use Lash Me by Yanira. These are the salty lashes. These are one of my favorite styles. They are so pretty, and you just plop them bad boys on there. Just like so. Let me get some tweezers so I can get them set on the side. Well, that's already stuck there. That's how easy that liner works. When you look at those lashes. They are so pretty. I love these lashes. They have a lot of pretty lashes. These are the salty, and I have a pair in the ball. I have the ball lashes from Lash Me by Yanira, and they are really good lashes. If you take care of them and clean them, they will last you a really good time. There goes our eyeliner. Like so. Get our other lash. And now we need some lips. We're going to do some lips now. Some lips. We need a neutral. Definitely a neutral lip. And pardon me, it's going to look like kind of bad at first, but I mix lipsticks. Every time I put on lipstick, I mix it. I don't think I've ever, well, I haven't in years, worn a color just like the way it's supposed to be worn. But I guess I'm going to use this lip liner. It is from the Color Workshop. I have no idea what shade it is because I can't see it. Okay. You will, more mature ladies know what I'm talking about. When that eyesight goes, it goes. They said I wear glasses, but you can't put makeup on when you're wearing glasses. And I can't see with the glasses on either. So. But somehow it always works out. Okay, now we got that on. I feel like I have been going in slow motion. Okay, I don't know how I want to do this. Do I want to go neutral, or do I want some color? Well, let's go neutral. The lip liner will give us some color. And I use this over the top of no matter what I wear. It's from Sephora. And I really wish, I guess the name of Rouge. But I really don't know the name of the color. Because the sticker is gone off the bottom. My lips are peeling again. Does anybody else have problems with their lips peeling? I'm talking bad peeling. I do all kind of lip scrubs. And it doesn't do any good. My lips are so dry. They're not just dry, they are dehydrated. And they've been that way since I was like 16 years old. And it's so bad that they crack and peel. I mean, the skin, layers of skin peel off my lips. If you have any of that kind of problem and you have found something that works, let me know down in the comments section, because I have battled it and have never found anything that actually, I mean, I have temporary fixes that I can use, like the lip scrubs and lip balms, and it's temporary for a few hours, but to say that my lips are ever hydrated and soft and plumping, they're not. Not anymore. They haven't in years. Anyway, I'm going to go in with, this is from Sun and Glory, Sexy Mother Pucker. I said pucker. It's a lip plumper. And we're going to put that over the top just to give us a little bit of shine. Because I like a little shine. And there we go, ladies. That is our look for today. Is, I guess you could call it my camo green. I hope you enjoyed it. If you liked the video, let me make sure I don't have any lipstick on my teeth. No lipstick. Yay! Anyway, if you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up.
and share it with somebody you think might like it. And I'll see y'all next time.